Welcome everybody and thank you for joining me. So GameStack Live has been taking place over the last couple of days and there is plenty to discuss. GameStack Live is an event that Microsoft had to showcase the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S consoles to developers. They showed the best features and functions this generation has to offer, and by doing this it ensures better games created by the best developers in the business. GameStack is a huge event taking place over 2 days, so as you can imagine there is plenty to unpack, too much for this one video. So today I'm just going to be breaking down two presentations that was done, both pertaining to Minecraft and ray tracing, introduction to real-time ray tracing with Minecraft, and how Minecraft is bringing real-time path tracing to its creators. Now I already discussed Minecraft and ray tracing extensively, to the point where I feel like there's not really anything left for me to say regarding this topic. However, I made a bunch of videos predicting GameStack Live, so I feel that it would only be appropriate that I close the loop and actually talk about the results after GameStack Live took place today. Now the information shared at this event today might not be what you want to hear when it comes to ray tracing on the Xbox, but be that as it may, this is the information that was shared with us, so that is the only information that I can share with you. Now these presentations was done by Mojang and Nvidia, and just to make sure that everybody understands, I will say this once again, GameStack Live is meant for developers. These presentations are done to show how features work, what features are being worked on, and how it is being implemented. It is not for gamers. Even though these presentations are done by Nvidia, it is still relevant for all platforms, be that console or PC. So I hope that everybody can understand how this actually ties into the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S. But now that all of that is out of the way, we started things off with a prediction, so let's just end things with the recap. Now also a disclaimer right off the bat, when it comes to these features, we did not get any release date, so I will not be discussing that. I have made videos about Minecraft and ray tracing and the potential release dates on console, so if you are interested, you can go and check that out. For today, we will be breaking down the two presentations and all the important information. I will try my best to show off as much of the demo as I can, and I will also be linking to both presentations in the description, so please feel free to go and check that out. Now I'm not going to lie, the whole event was a little bit of a snooze fest. It was highly technical, but again the truth is this event was not meant for us, it was meant for developers. It might have been boring at times, but it was also very informative. Nvidia has been working with Microsoft to help introduce mesh shading, variable rate shading, sampler feedback, and DirectX ray tracing. DXR in particular has redefined the look of video games, mirroring how lighting actually behaves, improved shadings, accurate global illumination, and physically correct reflections, combined to the set of new graphic standards. Games like Minecraft, Cyberpunk 2077, and Fortnite have all taken advantage of DXR, and the results are breathtaking. And that's a quote directly from Gianna Liu, links will be down in the description. Now these presentations had the right focus. They did not discuss what ray tracing is, but why you should care about ray tracing. A large focus was global illumination, and by using global illumination, things can be simplified quite a bit and the focus shift per pixel. Now an example of illumination was actually showcased, where you see nothing but the sky and the sun, and then they use that lighting to completely just light up a patch of the cave, and by using these advanced techniques like global illumination, it can accurately reflect the light and the shadows as it would in real life. You can see the ambient conclusion as the light bounces, making dark corners less dark, making it completely light up. Important sampling was another big pillar of ray tracing, starting off with uniform sampling, which is the shooting of rays randomly but uniformly randomly. They showed like a random bunch of 2D points in a range of 0 to 1, and then they showed the important sampling and how that comes in to ensure more rays in more important directions, fewer rays in less important directions. There was also a focus on specular important sampling. A specular BRDF can have complex shapes, and unlike the Cosen weighted distribution, they have parameters. Denoising was another big focus point, and this makes real-time ray tracing possible. What they do here is they look for pixels that is very close to one another and very often similar lighting environments. The surfaces presented by pixels that often have very similar lighting environments in nearby frames. Denoising can share lighting samples between nearby pixels and across frames and appropriately effectively increasing the number of samples available per a pixel. Now I'm going to end things here with the first presentation because I'm sure by this point I've probably lost most people as things are just getting more and more technical, but I share these technical aspects with everyone as it provides some much needed detail and context into what exactly it takes to bring ray tracing to the Xbox. The level of details that go into this is just crazy. It is still new to many developers who doesn't actually know these things yet, which is why Xbox is not only working with AMD on ray tracing for Xbox, but also has a large focus on in-house ray tracing, and they also rely on Nvidia for assistance. But let's just look at a few more things, specifically how Minecraft is bringing real-time path tracing to its creators. So this presentation at GameStack was not as technical and instead focused a lot more on features, which I really appreciated as someone who does not know anything about game development. They showed dynamic global illumination, soft shadow and true ambient occlusion, real-time reflections and accurate light transmission through varying IROs. Now for the demos in this presentation, they specifically focus on path tracing, that is a form of ray tracing, and they do this to allow for more natural and more realistic outcome of color transmission and bounce lighting. They also showed us more physical based rendering and a simulation of real world lighting. Again, they showed off some beautiful demo images and in certain cases videos. Now it's very difficult for me to play it in this video because of the nature of the presentation, but again, links are down in the description. Now the color temperatures, the shading, the lighting and just the overall world looked really amazing. I was definitely a fan of the second presentation, maybe just because I'm a sucker for video presentations, but I'm going to wrap things up here. Please go and check out the links for the presentation. Even if you don't understand the technical stuff, you can still at least enjoy the visual aspect and be very excited for what they are working on. Ray tracing on consoles might still be ways off, but I do hope that this gives you some type of understanding of what work goes into ray tracing and Minecraft, and what goes on behind the scenes and what they actually need to do in order for this feature to make its way to the consoles. We have a major update coming to Minecraft later this year, and hopefully with this update we can finally enjoy ray tracing for Minecraft on the Xbox consoles. But as always, thank you very much for watching.